So this right here is the slide so far. These are dried out. And now, in order to make, basically we need to make the chamber and the barrel for the strip light. So the barrel, you can either use a nerf of gun barrel or a little tube thingy or anything, but I don't have many options, so I'm gonna just make a paper tube. That's a tube I made, which actually can fit pretty well in the barrel. Just let's size it until here. I need to cut it. Don't cut it exactly at the barrel, you should leave a little edge. See this little edge thing. Now I'm gonna slide it out and I will make the chamber, which is again pretty easy to make. Just take another small piece of tube or paper for me. Let's make it right here. So you get this paper right here, so when you, let me just slide it in for now. So it will be much closer to the base. And now, I'm gonna take a little strip of cardboard. I think this should be good. Then with your finger make it circle sort of thing. This, and now with a little bit of glue you should apply it on here at the back. So this will form the chamber for the gun. So take glue and apply it on. So I applied it, and obviously again I used paper for stability, and just use some more. And that's the final assembly of the chamber. So let's test it. Yeah, it can fit. Now, if you'd like, you can take some aluminum foil, a little strip of it basically, let's size it with the chamber, cut it, and apply it on the chamber, so the port right here will be silver. Just for good style, I'm gonna go ahead. So there it is, the silver version. So when you put it in, let me just, yeah, see, very very cool silver chamber. Now on the finished barrel you can also add a recoil spring, that's from an airsoft, not too strong recoil, otherwise this plate will broke off. Yeah, so it will be here, and then when you pull it you have recoil. Just not too strong. This was basically from an old toy, not exactly airsoft, sort of an airsoft gun, sort of. Now I'll show you how to install this on the gun. So we have the gun here, and I'll show you how to install it in a minute. Just okay. So you basically get it out, and you need to glue it on here. see on this cardboard piece right here. You can use also paper craft, pieces of paper with glue. So as you can see here, I installed it. I put also this little stand because otherwise it will fall off. And now make sure you glue it very, very, very well. Otherwise when you charge the gun, it will come off. So yeah, you see I've added a lot of paper to hold it there, even behind it, right here. And now you basically leave it to dry out. So here it is, it has dried out and it is pretty stable as you can see with the recoil here. And that's the slide, and if I put the slide here, it already looks pretty cool. As you can see, you will be able to charge the weapon, and then the hammer works. So now, as you can see, the slide can open up from the back, and I'm gonna show you how to stabilize it. You basically take a little strip of cardboard, and let's slide it out, and you cut it the size of this thing a little bit, and we're gonna glue it right here until the board. You see, this reaches this line right here. I think it needs to be a bit shorter. Alright, make sure it can reach the line the port starts. And if I put it right here, it will be right. Okay, but before we glue it here, you need to take a pin. This is actually an old ink from a pen with a little bit of tape around, and you remember there's a little paper tube here, so the plan is you push the pin in, oops, wrong side, push the pin in, and this can go up, so the slide will be stabilized. So you will glue the pin here on the cardboard, then you will glue the slide on it. It's pretty simple, and it can slide in and out. Now slide it out, and you need to glue it here on the cardboard. So here it is, the pin assembly. It hasn't dried out yet, of course. As you can see, it's a pretty simple thing to make. And now what you got left to do is basically glue it on here, on the gun. Right here, but first I need to make it a little bit shorter. Make it a little bit shorter, about a little bit more than the end of the port, and you take it and you glue it on here. And here it is. You can see the pin right here and from the port, and make sure it's as straight as possible. I used also a little bit of paper. Now you leave it to dry out, and after that I'm gonna show you how to very simply install it and then paint the gun to complete it.